Welcome to Excel Tips and Tricks. My name is Andreas de Jong. Sometimes Excel cannot read dates because they're in a format which is different from your regional settings. In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve this problem. Here we are in Excel. We have some data. Let's make a copy of it because it's always good to work on copies rather than original data. We're going to rename it data. And if we click up here, select everything, and then double click between the columns, it should open itself up a bit so that we can read all the numbers. Actually, let's open it up a bit more. Okay, what I'd like you to notice is that columns B, C, and D containing the data is all aligned to the right, whereas this one here with the date in it is aligned to the left. What this means is that Excel thinks that this is a text and that these are numbers. Let's create a few new columns first, make some space here. And one thing we can try to do is to times this by 1. Unfortunately, we still get an error, which means that Excel does not recognize this as a date. So what we'll have to do now is to split this up because we have month, day, and year, and then stitch it back together again. But what I'll do first of all is to copy it and insert it, because what we'll do next is to split it up. So we go to data and use this function here, text to columns. Now we've got two options, limited or fixed width. And it likes to use fixed width, but as you can see, there's some numbers with two digits and that will create a problem. So we're going to use delimited next, and the delimiter can be a space, but there's also commas. So let's select commas and space and press finish. Okay, it has done it quite nicely. We have here the month. I think what I'll do first of all is to convert everything into a table so that it looks a bit nicer. So go to home, format as table, and select any one which you like. My data has headers. Let's get rid of the filter button. Okay, so to put them all together, we'll use a concatenate function, concat. And the first one is the day, comma. Let's put in a separator, another comma, then the month, comma, another separator, comma, and the year. Close brackets, press enter. You'll immediately notice that it has aligned itself to the left, which means that Excel thinks it's a text. So let's try this trick, times it by 1. Yes, it has aligned itself to the right, which is a good thing. Let's format it as a date and press OK. So now we need to check if this is the same as this here. So January 1st, 2005, and maybe a bigger number here, December 19th. Yes. So it has worked very well. I want to get rid of these original columns. What I'm going to do now is, so what I want to do is just copy it and then paste 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's got rid of all our formulas, and now we can happily just delete these columns and let's rename that as date and maybe format it a bit. Okay, that looks nice. So maybe you're all wondering what this data is. It's actually some gravity data. I'll make a quick graph of it. Insert. We'll use the line. And then I'm going to also move it to a new sheet. And it's got some negative numbers in here. So let's put the x-axis at minus 20. And also set this to minus 20. And I'm going to format this change the number to just show the year, and maybe also start it at plus 20 so that it's a bit more balanced. Change the title and let's make this a bit bigger. Chart design, add some elements, the grid lines, maybe some vertical grid lines as well. Axis, primary axis, labels. So if you think the lines are a bit too jagged, we can smooth them. Right click, format data series, and here under the bucket, you'll see an option called smooth line. But of course, you're gonna have to do that to all of the different lines. And sometimes it might be difficult to select them all. But okay, I think that's all of them selected and it looks quite nice. Thanks so much for your attention. I hope you found it interesting and useful. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below this video. I hope to see you on the next video.